Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to Toothpicks. Hey, I got another video for you guys today. It's a simple one, but I promise you're going to like this one. I'm doing some half chickens on a Weber Summit today. Just had them in the fridge, decided to take them out, and decided, you know what, before it gets dark, got a little more extra sunlight because daylight savings time, but before it gets dark, let's go ahead and put these on. Shouldn't take that long to do them, but hey, if you like it, at the end of the video, make sure you subscribe and share, show your friends, anything you want to do. Stay tuned. All right, guys. So what we got here are some half chickens. They look like whole chickens put upside down, but they're actually half chickens. And the reason I say that, the only thing you got to do on these guys, and I saved some time today, is all you got to do is turn your chicken over, the whole chicken, split the backbone by cutting down both sides of the backbone, kitchen shears, and then you just turn it over, flatten out like a spatchcock chicken. That's one of the videos I did a long time ago, maybe a couple years ago. You can refer to that just to see how you spatchcock it. But all I do from there, once I flatten it out, is take it and take a knife and cut right down the back. And as you can see, we just use one hand so I can season these things. I got them, they look just like that when you finish. Right down the breast, cut the backbone out, flatten it, and there you go. And that's all you do. So, you know, when you go to a restaurant, you usually see them just like this. If you ask for half a chicken, or they'll cut the leg and the thigh and be a breast and the wing separate. So I'm gonna turn these back over. Seasons I'm using today, guys. I got some lemon pepper garlic made right here in Coppell, Texas. This is some good stuff. I recently just started using this. This is by Suckle Busters. And I'm telling you guys, it's really for like seafood, but I like it on chicken. And I got some Saison seasoning right here. This is from your maybe your Mexican seasonings or your Latin seasonings, however you may say. That's pretty good stuff. And what I'm going to be hitting you with today, guys, once it starts getting well into its cook, is I got some the Flamin' Chicken Wing Sauce, creamy garlic parmesan, and this is made out of Keller, Texas. They got a lot of these sauces. I get this at my local butcher, which is Texas Beef Slags, and I'll have a link to that in the bottom of the description. You can check them out and get some of that stuff, or you can just find these guys online and order it and send it to your home. All right, so guys, let's get to some seasoning. Let's go ahead and do it. What I'm going to do first, guys, I'm going to season the bottom half of this chicken first. And I really like seasoning. And we're not going to be shy at all. I'm going to get it on here. Get it all there in the breast of the meat right there. I want my seasoning everywhere. Get it on the same. That's the other one. You want people to taste flavor, guys. That's one thing I don't cut back on is flavor. I like to get it on there. Get it all in there. Check your bottle up so you get some seasoning even. Out, get it all on the bottom of there. Some people will hit this with a little olive oil. I'm not gonna do that today, guys. I'm just gonna hit this straight with the rub. I want my skin to be a little crispy, and I'm gonna hit it with the Saison season, just a little dash of that, not overbearing on it. Real good stuff, guys. And don't mind the noise, I got people cutting grass today, so I know you hear any of that. That's them. I usually get out early and do that, but have my son do it. He's 15 now. He just turned 15. So, you know, he's been doing it, but you know, that's his job, not mine. All right, so we're gonna hit this, the other side, with the same thing. Now, one thing about this, guys, I'll pull some of this skin back. That way I can get under the breast meat right there and under the thigh meat. And then right there, you just hit the rest, sprinkle your wings, get all that right there. The reason I do skin side last, guys, is I wanna definitely, this will be my presentation side to whoever I'm feeding this to. Go on, season under there, get some of that salt. This got some salts in it. It's gonna help crisp up that skin. There you go. Get it all on there. Like I said, get under the skin. There you go. Same way I kind of would do some leg quarters, then come back take your seasoning of Saison and hit it with like a duster. Duster the Saison seasoning. Get that seasoning all over it. And there you go. And so the next thing, once you get that, you know, you can let them set in the refrigerator. Maybe an hour if you want. You can let them set them overnight. But I'm going to get these bad boys on. I got my fire already going. I've already taken it. And what I did was, you know, set my indirect cooking up. And I set it to my charcoals to one side of my Weber Summit. And have a free side that's no charcoal, nothing burning, that I'm going to set these chickens on. And that's how I'm going to do it. Indirect cook it. I'm going to do these above 300. Don't want to take all day. And we're going to put them on. All right, guys, so what I actually did, guys, I got some wood right here that I add, and it's burning up pretty good. Add a couple more pieces on here. Can go up to my bag so I won't get in the way. Add them on there. They're gonna burn pretty good because the heat's pretty high, but I just want to hit them with a hit of smoke. If I was smoking them really, it probably would burn a little slower. Go ahead and put that on there. Got, like I said, your chickens over here, they're already starting to brown a little bit. And go ahead and close your lid. Bring your temp down by closing your vents. And you should be ready to go. And you know I had to go ahead and do it to you guys. I had to pour me up some little whiskey today. Keeping it straight, simple. Got my Maker's Mark here today. And also, guys, I'll be using my little trusty old Thermopop pen right here. This is probably one of the more inexpensive version. What they offer on their sites, guys, you got to go check them out. They got a lot of products on there. I'll be ordering some of the other thermal pens, like the new IR. I've been looking at some other guys. I've been seeing on YouTube have it. I mean, it measures that your direct surface temperature. I think that's cool, all in one. Your internal temp of your meat temps can be done with this. But if you want that, you know, instant read for the surface temp, you got to get that IR, and I'm going to be ordering that also, and probably some other products here in the future. But I'll be using this today, guys. I don't know where my little cover is, but I've been keeping it here just so I can use it. So stay tuned. We'll be looking at the chicken in a minute just to see how it looks. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at these bad boys. Ooh, look at that color on the thing. That looks real nice. Getting kind of a little dark, like how I like it. So what I'm gonna do now, let's take the temperature real quick. Do it in the deepest part of the breast. Getting like 140. About 142. All right, so I'm gonna before this fire comes way up, put some of this sauce over it, because I want to put a couple coats over it. Try not to get all the seasoning. Right now the seasoning kind of should have set in. I'm just going to, you know, dab it some more, put this over this. It should spread out over this chicken. Even if you want, just pour it over. Just that. Then you can kind of spread it out. I mean, this fire is coming up, guys. It's getting a little hot. It's okay. I'm gonna get it all over them legs too. And if you need some more, just get some more. But I think this will be good for right now. I'm gonna switch arms because my arm is burning up. Just keeping it real. Hold your hair over that heat a little more. It's going to burn up. Get over those wing tips. All right. We're going to close the bag, let it cook a little more. We'll come back and check on it. All right, guys, so this chicken is about done. We're going to go ahead and pull these off. These look good. I mean, oh, Lord. See that little white sauce stayed on there? I'm going to take them off. Go ahead and put them on my little tray that I had from earlier. Got that washed off and getting ready to show you what these things look like. So the internal temperature, if I did not mention it, you want to bring these up to at least 165 in the deepest part of the breast. It's usually going to be about 180 in the dark meat, 175 maybe. What I do at this point, guys, I'll probably bring this all the way up, get it about 500 degrees, that way I can clean my grill off. So let's go ahead and close this. All right, guys, I had to switch cameras because my battery went out in my other one. Just look at this chicken, guys. The white sauce got up on there. Looks real good. What I'm gonna try to do, I'm gonna try to cut this with one hand just to show you how tender that is. And guys, I want you to see something. Look at that meat, the juice right there. Looking real good, guys. Perfect. So like I said, I got this up to 165 internal, about 175 in the dark. And there you go. Let's look at that again. It looked real good, guys. All right, so if you like this video and you want to try it, you know, don't forget to subscribe and share and, you know, hit the like button, make a comment. Until next time, guys, I'll be putting out another video soon, hopefully soon, between all my schedule and everything, and I hope you like this. Till then, toothpicks. Thank you.